You are about to see, for the first time, the fake collar bomb that was put around the neck of schoolgirl Madeleine Pulver in a case that still captivates Sydney more than a year later. The man who put it there, Paul Peters, was back in court today as a judge decides his punishment. Here's Ellie Southwood.
The Pulver family arrived at court to come face to face with the man who subjected their daughter to unimaginable fear.
Are you hoping to get some answers today?
I'd love to get some answers, yeah. That'd be helpful.
But what would that mean to you?
A little bit of closure.
Their daughter Maddie was at home studying for her HSC when Paul Douglas Peters stormed in wearing a balaclava. Today, for the first time, we can show you the fake collar bomb he clipped around her neck. Attached to it was a ransom note. Today, Paul Peters' former wife, Deborah, told the court she's still close to Peters and speaks to him every night, but admitted not once has she asked him why he did it.
Do you find it strange that his former wife never asked him why?
Yeah, I do.
Psychiatrist Bruce Westmore says Peters can't even remember doing it and didn't know the Pulvers when he targeted their home.
From the family's perspective, it was quite helpful because I think we got a little more insight into what happened.
Through teary eyes, Deborah Peters told the story of a previously happy and lavish lifestyle, including a driver, maid and a mansion, adding while Peters worked from Asia, he paid her $15,000 a month for expenses. But then, she said, he became moody, started drinking more and became obsessed with a dark book he was writing. Inside court, not once did Paul Peters appear to look at his former wife, but he did appear to wipe away a tear as she began telling their life story. Deborah Peters says she still sees her former husband as her life partner and says if he can't return to the US, she'll come here to Australia to be with him.
Mr. Peters' defence rests on a claim of mental illness. His former wife says he is sorry. Ellie Southwood, 10 News.